Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Witcher 3 Blood and Wine DLC. We need to follow Milton to the place where the body
We
was
have killed
found.
Guillaume.
Palmerin oversaw his upbringing. Guillaume is his kin.
Alright, mutations in Grandmaster Witcher gear. In Blood and Wine, you can undergo additional Witcher mutations to unlock new capabilities. Soon you will run into a messenger who will deliver a very interesting letter. Read it and investigate the story of Professor Moru to learn more about these mutations. They say a master craftsman, so it looks like an armorer with a hammer as his head. Or no, it looks like the weapon, the blacksmith with a hammer as his head. Lives in Toussaint, who can craft Witcher gear of unequaled quality. What's more, you receive special bonuses for wearing all or part of a set of this extraordinary equipment. You will not regret investigating these new options. Alright. So that's cool. New gear, new mutations, kind of give you a new way you can arc your character path. I would assume, I might be wrong, but that's what it sounds like.
Can't get used to the way you knights talk, especially how you switch back and forth between flowery and, well, near normal.
We are knights errant in the service of her gracious magnificence. When we appear in her name or speak on her behalf, we are bound by tradition. No one here. They must have removed the body already.
Let's look around, make sure they didn't miss anything.
Okay, so here we go. We got some footprints.
Hobnailed boots, multiple sets of prints. Ducal guard, clearly. Let's see where they went.
Okay.
Walked along the shoreline.
Perhaps the body lay on the bank.
All right, we
Come
got
on.
new
Got guests.
enemies.
Careful.
Oh shit, these guys take like no damage. Okay, they don't do a whole lot, so that's good. Fuck you. I thought he was gonna do like a ranged attack right there. Motherfucker, either fight me. Get the hell out of here. Oh, they explode. Okay, that's great. I hate these enemies exploding. And, oh yeah, he's exploding. Get Gwen back on. What? Oh shit!
Drawn here by the smell of blood. Let's keep looking.
Okay, so they're like a new version of rot fiends. That's what it appears that they are. They're just a different type of rot fiend. Let's see here.
Anything taken by the current ends up in these shallows.
Yes, the stench is fierce.
Blood. Guardsmen pulled these nets out of the water, then cut the mutilated body free.
Okay, use your Witcher sense to search the nets.
Gonna dive in, make sure they didn't miss anything. Only blood-soaked scraps left of the victim's clothing. Good quality cloth.
A wealthy victim.
Oh, look, there's a chest. Toussaint Ducal Guardsman boots and florins. Okay, so here we go. No, what the hell? And then wooden spoon. This doesn't look like it. This is just a pat. I think I. Actually, no, I don't. It's a broken ore. Oh, I see something new. There we go. There we go. Alright.
Silk kerchief, monogrammed DLC. A noble's accessory, clearly. Need to comb the bank.
What the hell? I can't get up on the shore. I can't get up on the shore! Why can't I jump? There we go. There we go.
Look, a boat was launched here. Guardsmen must have loaded the body parts onto it, taken them somewhere. Need to find out where. I'd like to look at the corpse before it starts to decompose.
The inn. Its patrons must have seen the guardsmen, which direction they took. We should ask there.
One thing. Found a handkerchief in the water, monogrammed DLC. Mean anything to you?
Delacroix? It cannot be. Was it he the beast slew?
Seems so. Knew him well?
Long past. We were close friends once, but our paths diverged. He was a man of extremes, standing by his companions, no matter the odds, fighting his foes to the bitter end.
Foes? You have a lot of them?
He did. But I do not see what that has to do with the beast. Ah, Geralt, you've struck a raw nerve. Memories of a time long past, to which I'd rather not return now.
I understand. We can talk later. Let's go to the tavern.
I shall have to leave you soon. Return to court.
Barely got back to Toussaint.
A knight in the service of Her Illustrious Highness knows no rest. In fact, I feared I would return too late to fulfill my duty. Yet it seems I've arrived in the nick of time.
Alright, so that's the inn up there. Is there anything that I can loot? What's in this house, real quick? That's locked.
Once you have finished examining the corpse, be sure to report to Anarieta.
Anarieta?
Her Grace, the Duchess. I forget myself at times. We address each other by our first names in private. Never in Pomeran's presence, however. He finds such familiarity offensive.
Falling on an empty stomach.
A watering hole for traders, smugglers, boatmen. But you will find no better crayfish chowder in all Toussaint!
They say that the that sounds good. I love fish chowder. Like clam chowder, that's my shit. I love that stuff. Lobster bisque, that stuff. I love me some seafood soups and stews and chowders.
By my troth, could that be the musty scent of fresh pate?
Naught else, Sir de Peyrac Peyren. I see time has not dulled your senses.
We would be honored if you would join us. Your companion as well.
But why do I not detect even a whiff of crayfish chowder?
No soup today, on account of there being no crayfish. I reckon you've not heard, but all I caught was a corpse. I awoke at the crack of dawn, as I do each day, but when I looked up, I beheld a blood-red sky.
This corpse is precisely why we're here. For the man whom you've invited to join you at the table was summoned from a far-off land by Her Gracious Magnificence. He is tasked with tracking and killing the beast.
We invited two men to join us, yet since Sir de Peyrac Peyren in temperament is more akin to hare than hound, I surmise the other is the hunter, with whom do we have the pleasure?
Name's Geralt.
A humble introduction. You've clearly not tarried long with Sir de Peyrac Peyren.
Spare us the petty insults. Geralt is a master of the witchering trade. He has questions concerning the beast's last victim.
I was the one to find the corpse. The sun had just risen when I awoke, sat straight up in my bed, looked out the window, and beheld a sky red as blood.
Ask Geralt, please, or we shall be here till winter.
Must have been early in the morning. Went to check your nets and then...
I stepped out of my hut and saw...
By my troth, to the point, man! You found a body ensnared in your crayfish nets. We know this already. What happened then? Did you see anyone nearby? Did you spy anything noteworthy? Anything at all?
Not a soul around, just me. As for noteworthy, Well,
what did you see? But be warned, if I hear the sky was red again...
I saw a head bobbing, eyes bulging, the tongue blew and popped out. Next to it, a hand rocking upon the water.
Get a good look at the body parts?
They gave me such a fright, I bolted to town fast as my legs would take me, then returned with guardsmen who told me to keep out of their way. They had a hard haul. The parts were so tangled up in my nets, they were forced to cut them.
Need to examine the body. Know where they took it?
They ferried it across, then loaded it on a cart and hauled it to a cellar at Corfo Bianco to keep it cool, see?
What? Why, Corfo Bianco is Baron Rossell's estate. When he learns they've turned his cellar into a morgue, he'll set his hounds on them.
While you were gallivanting about the north, his vineyard was auctioned off.
Who was that woman who just left? Didn't see her before. Didn't notice her walk in, either.
Doubtless Linus, the innkeep's daughter. But hold, Geralt, because this is an outrage. Rossell's vineyard was auctioned off? Inconceivable!
It is no secret the Baron had gambling debts up to his ears. It finally came time to collect. His creditors auctioned off his property. The Ducal Chancellery bought it, in fact. Rossell now bunks with his brother in Vico Faro.
I told Rossell he'd get his comeuppance. How long can one draw on past heroics? His creditors must finally have defined that his promises meant nothing.
Such are the times. Today's knights are pale shadows of the heroes of yore.
It's true what they say. God sent the beast to punish us for straying from the old paths.
So folk think the beast's divine punishment.
Knights have turned their backs on the old customs. Where they were defenders of the duchy, they're now defenders of their own tushes.
Why, you insolent!
Let him talk.
The duchess trades in titles, grants honors to ill doers. We've strayed from the path of virtue, lost the gods' favor, so the gods sent retribution.
Don't listen to that nonsense, Geralt. It's rehashed street preacher codswallop.
Yes, the rebel rousers have been sprouting up like weeds lately, each offering the same bill of goods.
They say anything else about the beast, besides it being a messenger of the gods?
The Toussaint Trois are no fools. They see clearly the beast kills on days honoring patron saints.
Picky monster. Thanks for the hospitality. Time I examined the corpse.
Corvo Bianco lies a short way from here, near the tourney grounds. Just follow the road and you'll arrive.
Not coming with? Oh yeah, duty of some sort calls.
Some sort? Her Grace bestowed a great honor on me, even before we departed for Velen. I'm to play the hare during this year's game in the palace gardens. When you see me in my costume, you will wet yourself laughing.
A little tempted to ask a few questions, but it sounds like a long, complicated story. One involving lengthy digressions into local history and tradition. So, see you later, Milton, and good luck.
All right. What the hell? There we go. All right, let's hit up this notice board outside here, see what we got quest-wise. I'll go ahead and read all of these out loud. All right, you turd. I hereby declare that William of Stratford steals rhymes, prostitutes his services for pennies, and smells of weak-old fish pricks. I cordially wish him the clap, ringworm, and warts within his bum's ample crevice. Take that, Le Papillon. Alright. Wanted the White Wolf. The Witcher Geralt, known as the White Wolf, is wanted to serve... Wait, I already did this. No. Did we read this? I don't know. We'll read it again. The Witcher Geralt of Rivia, known as the White Wolf, is wanted to serve as a guide. His potential employer guarantees an ample wage for this unusual contract. For more information, he should go to Count Belladol's temporary base camp in Toussaint. Note. We kindly request all other persons not present themselves at said camp under the pretense of being Geralt of Rivia. Count Belladol was not born yesterday and can easily tell who is a witcher and who is faking it. All those journeying to his camp in shabby costumes with wooden swords strapped to their backs can save themselves trouble and turn back. The fact that they needed to add that, that's like the shit that we add nowadays in, like, real life, like, on warning labels and like, post-it notes like that. That's how stupid people are sometimes, like people are stupid, and then they assume everybody else is as stupid as they are. Alright, so we got that. Notice from the Ducal Camerlengo, calling all knights errant of other and other strong men. The duchy needs you. Your aid is required. Bounteous rewards are in the offing. More details available at the Ducal Camerlengo's office on Knight's Dormant Square. Alright, announcement from the Office of Internal Revenue of the Duchy of Toussaint. The Office of Internal Revenue hereby announces a limited live auction to... Oh, nice. I want to go to that. Regarding the sale of a piece of developed... Oh, I can buy a house? And accompanying if I can buy this house, that would be dope. I'd be stoked if I could buy a house. Developed, and then you can, like, buy, if you can buy furniture, if you can have a house and you can buy furniture and shit, and you can get paintings and all that garbage up on walls, and you can have, like, a collection area, dude. This game moved up to, like, it was already in the top five, like, Witcher series is already in the top five. Games a lot. This, if it has that, this might catapult it all the way to number one. But let me get back to reading this. Agricultural land located in the Caraberta Woods region, having been left to the ducal treasury by the late Count Crespi, who departed this world without any heirs. Due to the unique nature of the Bellegarde estate and its important role in the production of wine, bringing great fame to the duchy and all corners of the world, only subjects of the Duchy of Toussaint shall be allowed to participate in the auction. To all knights-errants and other such men-of-arms, be it known far and wide that the services of voluntary keepers of the peace shall be needed. Minor problems are expected to arise during the transfer of the above-mentioned real estate, and said problems, for their dissolution, could require the application of direct physical force. All volunteers are asked to report to the field office of the Procurator General of Toussaint near Plegman's Bridge. That is to say, to the place where the auction shall be held. So that more sounds like I'm a bodyguard. I don't get to buy the house. That's disappointing. The Gwent Tournament. Let's go. The Great Belclair Gwent Tournament. I think that Beauclair? I think it's Beauclair, not Bel... Oh, it's not Belclair, it's Beauclair, I think. It is Count Monier's supreme delight to announce a Gwent Tournament of his organization. So those wishing to take part should register at the Pheasantry. Please note this tournament features a new faction developed by Count Monier himself. Let the games begin. A contract for a Witcher/Witchers caravan expert. To a Witcher or Witchers, the Beauclair's... The Beauclair's Cooper's Guild is seeking an individual or individuals willing to escort a merchant convoy through an area threatened by the Great White Terror. More information can be obtained from Gaston Lagoff at the merchant's camp in the forest to the north of Coronada Vineyard. Magram Polain, Undersecretary for Threats and Risks Management, Beauclair's Cooper's Guild. God, so much.
Ducal clerks looking for help. Could be good coin to be made.
Okay, so, let's see. Let's go ahead and look at quests. So, here we go. Okay, so, Mutual of Beauclair's Wild Kingdom. Meet the merchant at the... Suggested level 40, freaking 6. I kind of want to do this Gwent tournament. But I think let's just go ahead. We'll start the next episode as long as I don't get into anything too big. We'll start the next episode with the Gwent tournament because I love me some Gwent. Okay, so there's no. In one of these episodes, I'm gonna need to ride. around. Since we're right here, let's go ahead and grab this question mark. But maybe in the next episode where I do the Gwent tournament, we'll ride around and hit up all the notice boards, because I'd like to get all of the quests so we know what we've got. Let's just go ahead and run. We're not that far. So we did pick up, what was that, 4 quests, which is really nice. I think it's actually 5 quests. It was 4 quests and a Witcher contract, it looked like. Alright. This is going to be guarded treasure, probably. Oh, I thought they would have put it down here. This would have been kind of a nice area, put an enemy. No, this is a monster den. What the fuck? What the fuck? Why are they fucking plants? What the hell is this? This is fucking weird. I can't move! What the hell? This is fucking weird. Oh my god, this is hurt. Can't move, let me run. This is the weirdest enemies in this game so far! I'm gonna die. Hold on, let me back it up. Oh shit, I need my Tawny Owl so I can put my Gwen on. You dick monkey, stop! Had enough of this shit, fuck you. Arch Spores. This is interesting. At least it's a new enemy, I guess. Oh god. What the hell? Come here, you little shit. I can't even hit it! What the fuck is happening? I can't hit it! It won't lock on. Come here, you little shit. Oh, fuck. Fuck you, you stupid arch spore. Okay, I think I get how to kill these. You kinda like gotta get on the side. Did they not drop any items? That's different.
Arcus spores will sprout again. Should destroy the area if I want to get rid of them for good.
Alright, let's blow this up. What does this drop me? Greater green mutagen, arch spore tendril, arch spore juice, monster spore. And then a bunch of stuff that usually gets dropped. Okay. Let's go ahead and head over to the objective. We'll see what this entails, and then we'll probably call it an episode. Eventually here, we're going to get to the point where we're going to go to... where we will get to really more...
Have to hurry.
I could do it now, and do the, and start free roaming, but I kind of want to get this to a progression point that's good.
Must still be here.
Look for the body of beast victim and use your Witcher says to determine what kind of monster killed the guards.
Throat torn open by man-like jaws, man-like except for long fangs.
Kind of sounds like a werewolf or I see the guy calling. Okay.
In the cellar, gotta be.
Why can't I examine this body?
River
what
Monk
the hell?
Carried the body in this cart.
Okay.
River Muck carried the body in this cart. Attacker had no trouble knocking over the cart. Claw wounds from 5 separate claws, spread of a small human hand, massacred. By a vampire. Not an Ekimara, though. Or a Fletter. Bruxa. Gotta be. Footprints. Small, bare feet. Lead deeper into the cellar. Fell down the stairs. Broke his neck.
Okay, let's go ahead and read the bestiary on this. It would be under... vampires. Here we go. Okay, so that's what that girl was that we saw. That's what it looks like. Oh my god. Okay, we'll read it. This is supposed to be 100%. It's what I'm going for, so that involves me reading a lot, but we'll do it. If you must travel through the woods, steer clear of any places where you can hear several different kinds of birds at once. That sound means you're entering a Bruxa's territory and can kiss your life farewell. Anonymous piece of advice. Unfortunately for us all, Bruxa? I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's gotta be one of those three, I would think. Are rare creatures. Most live far from population centers, for they are care greatly for their own safety and make their lairs in places where they cannot be taken by surprise. Those who decide to live near men avoid crowds and emerge from their shelters only at night. When they do, one could almost mistake them for delayed travelers hurrying towards their night's lodging. Yet subtle details give them away. Their close ties to birds, their piercing voices, and the breathtaking speed of their movement. I guess I'm just going to call them Bruxa. Bruxa are far swifter and stronger than men, but their greatest asset is their ability to turn invisible. Oh, that's just great. Bruxa dart about with uncanny speed, and with their power of invisibility, they can easily confuse opponents and attack unexpectedly or from behind. Thus, when fighting these vampires, the Moon Dust Bomb is a great aid. While it cannot eliminate the vampire's invisibility altogether, it can make it easier to track their motions. A generous smearing of vampire oil is also effective. Bruxa use their sharp claws to attack and can easily break through an opponent's guard by buffeting him with a hail of blows from all directions. They will try to bite their prey and drink its blood once it is weakened. So every witcher who expects to encounter such a monster should swallow a black blood potion beforehand. Bruxa are also known for their sonic attacks, which knock down and stun their prey. So, suggested stuff to use: Moondust Bomb, Vampire Oil, Black Blood Potion, and the Erden Sign. I don't think I have the Black Blood Potion. Can I create it? Can create a new bomb, dimeridium bomb. How do I not have that made? Oh, here we go, enhanced dimeridium bomb. Okay, decoctions. Do I have the vampire decoction? I think I do. That's good. And I think I don't have the superior vampire oil, but I should have the regular. I'm missing one vermilion. I really haven't been spending too much time. I've just been creating these as I go, like, I haven't really been dicking around, like, specifically buying materials to create all the potions. I've just been going as I get the items I craft, but maybe I should, in this, kind of get more of them done. But let's go ahead and take a look. Do I have the Black Blood Potion? Alright, here we go. Oils. Do I have a vampire oil? It should be one of these, right? Relic oil, Ogroid. Oh, do I not have it? Oh, here we go. Enhanced vampire oil. Nice. Alright, so. Go ahead and put that on my silver blade. Do we have the black blood potion? Oh, here we go. Enhanced black blood. Witcher's blood injuries and knockbacks. Witcher's blood injures and knocks back vampire. Oh, okay. That makes sense. Witcher's blood injures and knocks back vampires and necrophages when they wound him. Okay, can I just drink this? It lasts for 45 seconds. Let me go ahead and put it on over about my extra swallow. Go ahead and do that. And we need, it suggested we put on Moondust, so enhanced Moondust. Let's go ahead and put that on. And I guess, let's put on a superior. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. Okay, I think we are good to go. Let's go fight this.
Black blood and Moondust could be lifesavers.
There we go. Let's go enhance Thunderbolt, because I'll put that on first. I got over here, first of all. Any items or anything? Nope, just a dead end. I'm hoping that it's that oil is on.
Hurled against the wall with great force. Took a lot of strength to batter this down. Used this to batter down the grate.
Okay, we're good. Let's see. Alright, here we go. We're gonna get our fight.
You. Saw you at the inn. I know what you are. Don't know why you killed these people, though. Clearly wasn't for their blood. We don't have to fight.
You are wrong.
Oh, fuck.
I cannot let you leave.
What the hell just happened to her body? Okay, okay, we are partying. We are partying here off the bat. Shit. There we go. Oh shit. Well, this is gonna be an interesting fight. Oh fuck! Back it up! Back it up. Oh. This bitch is lethal. Oh god. I think I've decided that I'm not going to continue to level up, like, off-camera. I think I want to play it at this. I want the challenge. Fuck. Oh, shit. Fuck life. Oh, I missed the finish. Oh, shit. Get trapped in the corner. There we go. I got her bitch ass now. Bitch, would you stop blocking, you little shit?
Killed all these men to get to the body. What was she doing at the table, though?
Alright, what did she drop? Monster eye, vampire blood, vampire fang, vampire saliva, and greater blue mutagen. Alright, time to check out the table. Actually, check this guy out, loot him. Before I initiate anything else, I just want to take a quick peek around, see if there's any items or anything. Okay, I think we're good. Let's check out the body.
Stinks. Waterlogged, both hands amputated. Body was quartered, just as I thought. For some time. Head swollen, and something took a few bites out of it. Something in the throat. A pouch, bulging with coins. Nilfgaardian florins, from several different provinces. If the murderer did this, means we're dealing with a sentient thinking beast. Body was chopped up after death. Blows struck with great force, but bones sliced through, not crushed. Creature that killed him had long claws, sharp as a witcher's blade. First sank its claws into the victim's heart. No Bruxa did this. Third hand. A spare? Except it's clearly not the victim's. Guardsmen must have not noticed it as they picked everything up. How's this possible? Still warm. Blood still flowing. Several monster species can regenerate. Never heard of that happening to their severed limbs, though. Or of their limbs seeming completely alive after so much time. Examine the tissue more closely later. Might learn something. So, murderer was clearly a monster, but not a Bruxa. But then why'd the Bruxa come here for the severed hand? And who does the hand belong to? Why the hell's it still warm? Now, pouch shoved down the victim's throat. What's the significance? And why was he chopped up into pieces? Lots of questions, no answers so far. Need to know about the other victims. I'll ask Palmerin to get me in to see the Duchess.
Alright, now we need to find Palmerin and ask him to take us to the Duchess. So, we got that severed hand, so we're going to take and examine that later. I don't know why we just didn't examine it right now, but we're going to examine that later. Thought that was a ladder for a second. We'll examine that later. He had gold pouches. He wasn't killed by the bitch eating him and checking out the hand that he had. So I'm assuming he had the hand on him to begin with, and she took it off of him and was putting it into that pouch. But that's all we know. She wasn't in the mood to talk, so that's always great. But I think that's going to do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't. And I think in the next one, we are going to take on the Gwent tournament, because I love me some Gwent, so we're going to give it a go. Hopefully my deck is good enough, but I will catch you guys on that episode. Peace out.